And here we go with take three. Welcome to Josh Tam's video diary. So I finally worked it out. You can actually get the display info on the A7R as on a HDMI monitor if you're not using, if you're not shooting 4K. So let me show you what I mean. I have here another camera, the older RX100 Mark II, and I'm gonna switch to this camera right now. Well, here you see the Sony A7R Mark II, and I have got it hooked up to this mini adapter, and it's a little bit loose, not a very good connection here. It's kind of pulling on the cable, so I've got to fix that. I've got to get a sturdier connection or tie it up so there's no weight on it. But if you look behind me, I've got this cable running to the TV, and it's doing what I want. You can actually see the record button as well as all the detail that would normally be on the back here. Now that's off. What you're seeing is a reflection on the back of the camera onto the TV. But that's off, there's no display here. It's off, you see. It's being displayed on the TV, which is really good because I want to be here blogging. And I want to be able to see that, oh, I've got a full battery, I want to know it's recording, I want to know it's in focus, I want to know my framing's good, I want to know that it hasn't stopped recording because of this arbitrary 30 minute time limit. I want to make sure the memory card is not full. I want to know I'm at the right f-stop. All this information, I want to know I'm exposed correctly. All this information I couldn't get before because it's not supported on 4K. And I'm guessing it's because it's too much processing power for the camera to handle on 4K at the moment. So this is great. 4K, it would be cool, but I'm setting up a multicam little setup here. So I cannot have three cameras all running 4K. My computer, even though it's a pretty new, it's like a brand new iMac, 27 inch, souped up, the fastest iMac you can get. 4K is just so much, it's just so big, and it's actually a matter of disk space. I don't have the SSD card space, I don't have like terabytes of space required to run multicam on multiple cameras, or I don't have the fast enough RAID array. Now I do have a Drobo. I can show you that. I'm going to go into the next room, into the editing room. Computer's currently in standby, but I do have a Drobo, but Drobo is really slow. It's not fast enough. It's not designed to do multicam 4K video. You need something crazy. You need a Strive to RAID array. You need like seriously fast hard drives in parallel. Now, the Drobo is more of a backup device. It's more for archival, making sure you don't lose your photos and stuff. So it's not built for complete speed, complete raw speed. So anyway, that's why I'm not recording on, or I won't be recording the show on 4K. I will probably record a little bit of video on 4K, but 1080p for multicam is where it's at. And you know, the difference is one notch. It's not a huge difference, and I think it's better to have multiple cameras. So here's the setup. I do need to buy a proper cable so I don't have this precarious little connection here. If that will focus, you'll be able to see that. There it is. You'll be able to see that it's at an angle and it's still feeding the feed, but a little precarious. There is a little clip here, but that you can put. If this camera, A7R, comes with, it's right here. This little clip, which you can secure all your cables to. It's great for filming, but it won't fit because this adapter is too big. And if you followed my earlier videos, this little adapter, that was a cheap $19 one. So, well, I got a little HDMI extension with it, but I'm not gonna be able to use it. I have to get a mini HDMI cable, but that's fine. They shouldn't be too expensive. So there you go, it works. No 4K with this setup, but I get all the camera information I need, and it's going to do really well. So, anyone that's out there vlogging, this is the setup. You've probably got a TV lying around, anything that has HDMI or a computer monitor, you can set that up, you can monitor your camera, and it's awesome for vlogging. It also works on a lot of other cameras. Most cameras have a HDMI mini connection that you can do this setup for. So I'm gonna have better video, and I'm gonna be more confident recording videos that everything's going right. Because I don't have a camera operator available all the time, and when I'm just doing little blogs and stuff, I wanna know I'm getting it right. So this setup is gonna be used by me for not just multicam shows, but probably a little bit of blogging, vlogging, whatever you're gonna call it. So I'm really happy about that. Unfortunately, you don't get 4K for that. Maybe on my next camera, unless I use a different camera, which, well, you know, I've got all these options. I could use the Osmo, I could use the iPhone, but then I wouldn't get a monitor. Could use the GoPro and sync it to my phone. All these options, it's great to have options, but this is the nicest camera I have. Pity no 4K on this app. Sony A7R, and you can see that here on the RX100. There you go, A7R Mark II. They don't write the Mark II on the front, but they do at the back. There, we have focus. Okay, I've rambled long enough. Thanks for watching my little video test, and hope to catch you soon on Josh Tam's video diary. Bye. Stop recording.
And stop recording.